Wondershare Filmora 9 tutorial. Hello, what's up everybody, welcome back to my channel Digital Creations, and in this video editing tutorial we are going to learn how to use Wondershare Filmora 9 complete video editing tutorial for beginners. So let's get started. Before starting this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe my channel Digital Creations and hit the bell icon so you never miss my new latest uploads. So let's get started. Filmora 9, it is the simplest video editor for YouTubers and all content creators, so you will edit your videos in a very easy way. This dialog box is open when you open Filmora 9 video editing software. Here you see we can, before creating a project, we can select the project aspect ratio. So here by default 16:9 widescreen is selected. And you can select Instagram 1:1, different dimensions is here, so you can use it in your project. And here you can open your existing project and you will see your recent project in the project library. So let's create a new project. I'm going to click here to create a new project. Let's maximize this window. I don't need to just quit the tour. Okay, now guys, here this is the editing interface of Filmora 9. So here you see left side, this is the media library complete, and in media library you will import all your media including video clips, music and photos. So now guys, and here on the right side you see this is the preview window, downside the timeline. Okay, now guys, here you will find at the top of here you will find audio, titles and transitions, effects, elements and split screen option tabs here, so which is used in your projects. So now guys, let's import some media files. So before start importing media files, let's check this is the timeline or storyboard where we assemble all media for video projects. So, and here, this is the toolbar, different options here for editing. And now guys, here, I'm just going to import media files. You can click directly here by clicking this icon, import icon. So I'm just double click here. And I'm going to import media files, some video files. You can arrange, you can import in, there are three ways you can import media files, right? Double clicking the icon of media files and right click here to import options. So I'm just going to right click here and import some files like this images, sounds, and this one. Okay, all right. Different kind of medias, it indicates, this icon indicate that this is the music and video files. And you can sort out your media files by view, list view. And right click here and view the middle thumbnail view. Okay, all right. Now guys, another way you can import files from menu bar. So you go to file and import media and import your media files from directly here. Just grab this icons. Okay, all right. Another way is you simply drag and drop files directly into that folder. So I'm just going to select it and drag and drop these files here. Okay, it appear here. So you can easily import medias, any kind of media, sound, images and video clips here in media library. Now guys, after importing media files into Filmora 9, so I'm just going to add this media to my timeline. So just simply drag and drop media into timeline, drag and drop this media into timeline. Okay, now guys, here you see this playhead, and simply drag this playhead to the point you want to preview and press the space bar to play the video, and use and the short key is a space bar in the keyboard, and you can use it this button, play button here. Okay, and to stop you can again press a space bar to stop it. Now guys, again we just going to check another tools to edit our video and create stunning visual stories. So in the timeline you see this slider is available here, this slider. So this slider is simply, you just we drag this slider and simply to view the control, the timeline view, simply you see here. Okay, let's drag more clips into our timeline, different clips here, lots of clip I have. So I just make some stunning video story. Okay, there are lots of clips, so just simply click here. This is different clips in our timeline, and here guys, you add up to 100 video tracks into your timeline in Filmora. So here right side, left side, you see this plus button, you just click here and you can add a video track. So just add video tracks, so just click here, different tracks. So now guys, and you can add audio tracks as well. Okay, now guys, again just move this playhead. Okay, now when I select this video clip, you see upside there is some editing options available in the toolbar. You can undo your undo is from here as well, and the short key is Command Z, and in Mac and in Windows is Control Z. And here you can delete this clip, for example this video clip. I just select this clip and simply press here and delete it. And another way to delete the clip, just select this clip and right click here and delete. Okay, now guys, here again the other option is split option, so you can split your video clips into two pieces. So just going to select the clip, and this scissor tool is used to split the clips into two parts. So just move your playhead where you want to split it, so just select it and split, so it is split into two parts. Okay, now another thing is if you want to delete this part. Okay, so I'm just going to use the ripple delete option. So if you want to simple delete, it created a gap between two clips. So here I'm just select the ripple delete option to close the gaps created by removing the clips. So it is, and here is the option auto on and off, ripple off, and so you can select here. So for a ripple delete option, so I'm just going to select it, same. Okay, now guys, other options is here, you can crop your video so by clicking this button. So I'm just going to select this, and this window will open. And if you select a clip in the timeline, and or you can select for example, just right click here and crop and zoom. So here I'm just going to select this area, crop it, and here crop and zoom. Just move this playhead, and it's automatically you can change the dimensions of the video by clicking the preset here. So I'm just click here, crop and zoom to show you again. Here this area is crop, and you can here you can select the dimensions. So
that is crop your video clip. Okay, now guys, another is here you can change the speed of the clip, so slow, fast, select here different speed options here. This is speed option, so you select here, you can use fast option. Okay, the super fast. Let's play this. Okay, let's change the speed of this clip as well. Fast 20%. Now guys, you see here the zoom in and zoom out option available here, so you can zoom in and zoom out your video clips, and simply just use this slider, and this in upper right corner you see in the preview window, so you just click here and just zoom in and zoom out your timeline, and here is this icon shows zoom to fit timeline. And another is you can add some chroma green screen. I'll show you how. And here there's further editing option. Just select this clip and click here, and you can change the color. There are some built-in color presets also available, so but manually we can change the color, temperature, contrast, and some LUTs is also available here. Okay, now hit okay, and now guys you can add some title, simply drag and drop title templates. So here are some built-in title, lots of built-in title templates, so you can add in your projects. So just click here and drag and drop into your timeline. Simply play this. Okay, now guys you can remove this audio, just right click here, and here is the option detach audio. I'm just going to delete this audio and add some music. So go to media, and here is some music tracks I have. Let's trim this option. So for trimming, trimming a clip, just select this clip. And if you want to trim from the beginning, so just select here and edge of the clip and hover your mouse left to right, just trim this clip. And if you want to trim it from here, so use this. So you can easily, I just wanted to split this audio track and delete it. And now guys, let's play. Let's play. You can add transitions between the clips. So upside you see there are lots of built-in transition presets here. So just drag and drop between the clips and add transition. Thank you. And now guys, here is a some option of pre-render. So you just click here and for creating a bass smooth playback. So there is an option of rendering your files. Okay, let's preview this. And this green line indicates, let's stop this. This green line indicate that this is the pre-render. And now guys, we can add some effects into our video clips. So here, lots of built-in presets available here. So you can use for your effects and different elements as well. So you can just drag and drop these elements into your timeline. And I'm just going to change the playback resolution to better quality. Okay, now guys, here another, you can add some audio tracks is also available here. So you can download it and add into your timeline. I'm going to delete it and use this. Just split this clip from here and delete it. And now guys, this is lots of audio available here, audio tracks, so you can use it. And there is a split screen option available here, so you can use this split screen option. Okay, so another thing is you can use this option here. Just select the clip and double click here, and here you can use different transformation tool in your video. So you just click here and you can rotate your video, scale in and out, and different most option, which is different transformation tools here. So you can easily transform your video by using this option. Now guys, after adding some titles and music and effects, so you can export easily or share your videos directly from YouTube. So there is an export option, so you select the export option and this dialog box will appear. And you can there are lots of extra file formats here. You can save as a MOV file, MP4, or different devices as well. You can select it and you can share directly into YouTube to sign in here, Vimeo, and export to DVD. So I'm just going to select MOV file format or MP4. So, and here this is the resolution setting. You can change the resolution settings from here. Best quality, good. Okay. And here is the location where you want to save this file. And write the name of the video, click here and hit the export button. Now guys, in the end, if you like my video, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe my channel, Digital Creations. Thanks for watching.